Wait here. Stay here. But he said, no. I'm not staying here. It became more of a burden to Elisha than to Elijah to go forward. You see, when you have what you want already, you can be cool about it. But I don't get what I want yet. So you can sit down and take it easy. But I got to run. You have enough already. But you got what I want. So you can't sit me down. I know there are some folks who got sick before us. And they stopped shouting a long time ago. So they can't take the shouter. They stopped making noise long time. So they get upset when people make noise. But you've been there and done it already. It's my time now. Hallelujah. We're not going further. Well, you know, because the pastor will not exegete this text because there's so much to offer from the New Testament age. We preach today from the book of Hebrews. We talk about Jesus being the center of every text. He is in the midst of this. There's a demonstration, apostolic demonstration, that is in this text. Because Jesus said that he must decrease. John said, I must decrease and Jesus must increase. But when Jesus went up, he said, behold, I go, but I'm sending you a comforter. And then you got to tarry and wait at Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. Ah, glory to God. So in this ascension, there was a typology of the ascension of Jesus. So Elijah is a type of the church. Because after Jesus was ascended, then the whole apostolic gospel ministry was open to every believer. And so Elijah, there was no limit as to what Elijah could do. Now my intention tonight is to have you know that we're nowhere going in the rapture. How many know you're going in the rapture? But before you get to the rapture, there's still one more miracle. Somebody said one more miracle. I got one more miracle tonight. So somebody just one more. You got one more errand to run. One more message to preach. One more deliverance. One more preaching. Can we have just one more revival? Or a first United? Can we have one more revival? A gospel like, can we have one more revival? How do you know you want to go to heaven? But there's an unfinished task. There's still another work to do. Tell somebody one more miracle. Sit down like you know God has called you here for purpose. Now, amen, I thank you. Amen, Her Eminence again. I thank you. Amen, Apostle Dr. Amen Smith. I thank you. Amen, just about everyone, for your kind hospitality and the unity of the spirit over here. Amen, I admire the spirit of these two churches and these two pastors. Praise God, how they cooperate when it's time to shut down and lock down and unity. Let me tell you, the apostolic church is still alive. Yeah. Pentecost is still here. Yes. Folks are having all things common right here. Yes. I know some of you are looking at me like a fool. Yes. Praise God. I said folks are having all things common right here. Yes. Amen. There's an outpouring of apostolic blessing right here. We are in a good season. I appreciate what I said. It's good things. That's what Jesus said. Good things. There's nothing bad about the church. Everything's good about the church. And we're throwing our bad stuff. We're casting them away because God has positioned us in a good season and a good time. And he has deposited good things into us. God bless you, elders. God bless you. God bless you. Now I want to say this, beloved brethren, that when we came into this world, that God has appointed us for a particular season on this planet. And everyone who came, amen, into this world, you didn't come by chance. God had a plan and a purpose for your life. How many know God had a purpose for your life? It was not in the intention and will of God that you just born and die. Amen. But between birth and death, God had a plan, amen, for you to accomplish. Hallelujah. Things could have gone another way, for another seed could have been caught in the walls of the uterus. But God allowed you to be caught because God had a plan for your life. Now, I know that we are in the age where people don't respect life anymore. So people just take bring it out. And there are folks who just use their tongue and just kill people. Oh God, I know somebody looking at me funny. Mm-hmm. And if you read the book of James, you'll understand that the tongue has the power to murder. I'm not talking to anybody here. Many amen are with me today because they are murderers within the church. God bless you, women. Amen. They are murderers even within the church who use their tongue to cut down other people. And some of you are here, but you're just a shadow because you're not operating in your divine call. Because somebody shot you along the way and you're wounded. And then you see the church should have the power and do have the power to do resurrection business. But you see, like some of us are not in the resurrection business no more. And so when folks are cut down, ain't much persons trying to pull them up. But tell somebody, I'm not ready to die yet. God got a plan for my life. God has a lease on my life. God has a lease on my destiny. I want us to know that whatever God invests in, he intends to get profit. Ah, glory to God. You're not a prophet ever. There's somebody a prophet. And that's why if you're in a relationship and it is unprofitable, come out. If you're hooking up with anything that is not producing, get out of it. Whatever I join myself to, I want to see profit. So if you're not profitable, amen, to me and my life, then I'm cutting it off. Somebody give up. Spirit. And so God then allow us to be here because we are valuable. People are not like paper. You crush and crush and put in file 30. Am I talking to somebody here? Amen. It doesn't matter how crushed you might be and how messed up and dirty you are. God have a way of ironing you out. Remove the spots. Remove the wrinkles. Amen. And get you clean again. For God does not invest in anything to waste. Tell somebody, you're not a waste. Somebody, God got a lease on your life. How many of you know that God took another lease out on your life? Amen. There were many times you went to the edge of your grave. Amen. But you don't know how you came back. But God looked at your grave and said, you can swallow him up. You can swallow him up because I have investment. Somebody give God praise. And so then you should have been buried long time ago. Amen. But when the devil say yes, Jesus say no. Heaven called an election and the devil was voted out. You're on God's side. Somebody give God praise. Tell somebody, I'm on the Lord's side. As a matter of fact, the Lord is on my side. Hallelujah, glory. Even Joshua, amen, the priest who was about to lead Israel out of exile in their exilic prophetic moment. 70 years was predicted that they would have been down in Babylon. When the time came for God's people to be delivered, Satan struck at the right hand of the prophet. When God looked at him, his clothes was messed up. And the devil said, yeah, I'll get him now. But God said, watch this. Take off the clothes of him. Put on a new robe of him. And come on, now, Joshua, lead my people out. Somebody give God praise. You might have been messed up. But God said, it's not over yet. Tell somebody, you still got one more valley. You still got one more hill. You got one more trial. Somebody give God praise. How many of you know you got another mile to run? Tell somebody, I've got one more mile. Pain in my knees, but one more mile. Pain in my back, but one more mile. All cracks all over, but one more mile. The doctor even say you got blood sugar, but one more mile. Tell somebody, said over till God said it's over. Ah, oh, your destiny is not yet completed. You still got another run to do for God. That's why you pull yourself and still here. You've been wounded many times. And it looked like you would have been in your grave. But you can't keep quiet. Because God not done working through you yet. That there's a said how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment of flows from the beard of Aaron down to the skirt. That's where I come in. Whichever lady would say anointing is skirt. At one time the anointing was in beard. And we're going back to the beard generation. If you look around this house, glory, most of the young men are wearing a beard. But I thank God that there's an anointing in skirt tonight. Somebody give God a praise. Ah, that's what we need some people. Give God praise. Give God praise. So the ironic, amen, anointed servants are on the rise. But God is making room for everybody to prosper. I know we're on the edge like Elijah. Amen, to be caught up into the rapture. But the church has not finished our mandate yet. We are the called of the hour. You are the minister of the hour. You are the vessel that God is now working through. The Apostle Paul is gone. Apostle James is gone. Apostle Peter is gone. Apostle John is gone. Apostle, follow me. Come on, talk to me, somebody. Give me a few of Matthew on. Little God, you are the physician now. You are the miracle worker now. Elijah is gone. Elijah is gone. But there is a fountain here. There is a smith here. There are some crazy anointed men in this house that's ready to carry out the mandate. Oh, somebody said, I tell them one more miracle. I got to catch up with the apostles, but one more miracle. I got to catch up with Abraham, but one more miracle. I got to catch up with John, but one more miracle. Somebody give God praise. I can see them waiting, literally waiting. Because the Bible said, without us, they cannot be made perfect. Oh, they're crying out under the altar, said, Lord, how long? But Jesus take a peek over here and said, wait first. Because there is a climate down there. There is a young boy down there that has to make some accomplishment. Tell somebody, I've got time to waste. Some of you are sitting like you're here to spectate. Tell somebody, I'm on divine assignment. I've got one more assignment. I've got one more miracle. I've got one more demon to chase. Somebody, somebody give God a praise. Folks wonder why we're so busy. These folks, they don't sleep. They're coming from church after midnight. They're back at church the next day. Tell somebody, time's running out. But before time shall come to an end, I got to pull together what God tell me to pull together. For there is another life off of this life. And when I transfer from this life to the other life, I got the crown to wear. I got the ring with a stone. I got the robe to wear. Somebody give God praise. I'm not ready to sit down yet. I know some folks are telling you to sit down. Tell somebody, I'm not sitting down. Some folks are telling you to shut up. Tell them I'll be silent for longer. Open up your mouth and call on Jesus. Divinity locked up in humanity. There's a revelation of divinity that's about to come forth out of you. Tell somebody, tell them you're looking at divinity. Tell somebody, power is up in here. I know some of you broke, say, but I've got power. Some of you have no job, but say, I've got power. You might only have two pairs of shoes, but say, I've got power. You're not married yet, but say, I've got power. Some of you fell down, but say, I got power. Some of you weep, but say, I got power. Some of you upset, but say, I still got power. Some power in this house. And the power that you have is not to go back like you came. You're on top potential. You're on utilized potential. Look at somebody, tell them I have use. Tell somebody, you better treat me right. Looking at the powerhouse. Speak to somebody about to
Stop, hallelujah. Stop following. If you cut off from them, then the power will cut off.
Is there anybody in this house that knows that you want something powerful?